the number one contender.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing, from Tokyo, Japan, weighing at 192 pounds, Kushida!
Well, another Superstar Hoodie Championship matchup this past Sunday, Kushida, taking on the North American champion, which is part of the reasoning, Wade, behind why this matchup was made by Malcolm Bivens.
Yeah, well, Malcolm Bivens clearly feeling like Kushida is a soft target at the moment, perhaps carrying some war wounds from that battle he had with Johnny Gargano at TakeOver. And let's be honest with you, it's great strategy because it will be a huge scalp for Tyler Rust to claim if he can pull up a win today.
Well, as Kushida went 25 minutes this past Sunday with Gargano.
Yeah, I was just about to say that, Vic, and to add to that, I mean, the entire WWE Universe was watching that matchup. Keith Lee called Kushida a beast. Big E said he was a joy to watch in the ring. Kushida opened a lot of eyes at TakeOver Vengeance.
Also, what happened earlier tonight, how about Bronson Reed talking to Kushida, made his intentions known of his North American title aspirations.
Absolutely. Bronson Reed, a force to be reckoned with. I mean, we saw him all through the latter half of 2020 being a formidable force chasing after the North American title. And as you see, action in tonight's main event, six-man tag team match. Huge announcement from earlier. That one will be one to watch as well.
And what a main event that'll be, but Kushida locking up with Tyler Rustin. There's no way Kushida can be 100% following that matchup at TakeOver. And again, part of the reason, and you see Kushida a little gingerly moving around right now.
We saw that heat impact on his neck earlier. That elbow's clearly still giving him some grief. That's what you get if you get in the ring with Johnny Gargano.
Right now it's being in the ring with Tyler Rustin. Kushida trying to manipulate around Rustin. Take a look at the offense by Kushida. Kushida, of course, who we saw that heating pack took not one, but two. Oh! Huge one final beat. DDTs from Johnny Gargano. One in the ring, one on the entrance ramp.
Yeah, it took a lot to keep Kushida down. Such an impressive individual. Clearly wants to get back to winning ways tonight.
And I mean, if I'm Tyler Rust and I'm looking at this matchup, a win is a win is a win. A pinfall over Kushida would be absolutely incredible for his career at this point.
Well, it would send his career skyrocketing. It would send his stock rising like a Cameron Grimes option play.
Kushida backing off the offense right now. I want to bring that up. Do you believe Rust's stock is still rising here in NXT?
Well, that's an interesting question, and admittedly, he has stalled somewhat since that incredible debut he had a couple of months ago against Tommaso Ciampa. But this is how you get on the track. This is why he's paired up with Malcolm Bivens.
Nice arm drag, and look at Rust quickly shutting the door on Kushida. Kushida back to his feet, sliding through the legs, and a unique takedown. Kushida now. Oh, unique head, shoulders down. Rust having to kick out at two, and well, if there was any Rustish. Oh! I spoke too soon. What a vicious right hand by Rust. And I believe Rust is done playing around.
Kushida just took his eyes off Rust for a split second. And that was all that Rust needed. Such a predator in that ring.
Rust best not hesitate. Kushida with that lightning quick speed.
Bivens on the outside shouting to Rust. Kushida holding onto the top rope. Kick connects. Another kick connects as well. Rust is rocked. Kushida with the left arm. Kushida, over the top rope. And now Kushida focusing on a body part, trying to systematically dissect Rust. Rusto, too much time. Kushida, awkward landing.
And look at the neck of Kushida. Clearly took a horrible landing there.
Yeah, you can see the whiplash, Kushida's head snapping backward.
And we've seen Rust since that debut against Tommaso Ciampa. The superb submission skills on display.
Another look at that nasty fall here. Kushida trying to land on his feet, but momentum was not on his side.
That was the issue. He's lucky he didn't break his ankle on that landing. He landed one foot first. That is not how you want to land off the ropes. Clearly, as you were saying, about trying to protect that neck.
Oh, the bottom rope goes Kushida. And this is what Malcolm Bivens' point was. Kushida's not 100%. Can Kushida get back in this match against Tyler Rust? This one-on-one match continues here on NXT.